Hello and welcome to our New Harvest Long Beach YouTube channel. We're so glad that you joined us today. We hope that you enjoy the message. Please like and subscribe to keep up with all the upcoming services. Thank you, God bless and enjoy.
This afternoon I want to speak on a face in the crowd. And you know, we're in a time and a season where there are so many people that are lost, that are feeling struggling with anxiety and stress. And with the churches being closed and the different things taking place and everything closing in around them, they feel isolated. Even though they're in the midst of the crowd of people, they feel alone. But you know, the Bible says in Isaiah 55:11, "So is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it." You know, and we may not understand the full depth of everything that's taking place, but God's word goes out throughout the earth and it ministers, and it will accomplish, and it will reach those wherever they are. And, you know, we may feel kind of like, oh, the church is closed, or we can't be there as a family of God that we are. And what about the people? Because we have compassion for the people, those that are afflicted, those that are afraid, those that are frightened and have nowhere to turn. And they're looking to the church, but the church is a building. You and I, we are the church. And this morning, we want to be able to encourage others, and wherever we are, bring Jesus to them. Let them know that there's hope. You know, I want to look at the scriptures in the book of Mark today. And in the 5th chapter, verse 21, we find Jesus, and he comes at verse 21 and he says, "When Jesus had again crossed over by boat to the other side of the lake, a large crowd gathered around him while he was by the lake. Then one of the synagogue leaders named Jairus came, and when he saw Jesus, he fell at his feet. He pleaded earnestly with him, 'My little daughter is dying. Please come and put your hands on her so that she will be healed and live.'" So Jesus went with him. You know, Jesus could have easily turned away. Jesus could have easily said, "You know what, you guys have shunned me, you guys have pushed me aside, and you guys have discredited me, and all the things and the way they treated him because of the way that Jesus ministered." But he didn't. He had compassion on this man's daughter. And as he cried out, and he saw the pain that was in his soul, he felt it in his voice, and immediately the Bible says he turned and went with him. He didn't hesitate. He didn't stop. He didn't go backwards. He didn't cry out. He said, "You know what? There's a need here. This man, his daughter, is in great need." And so in that portion, we see that he begins to leave, and they're walking. And all of a sudden, the Bible says that a large crowd comes and begins to press around him. And you know, there's so many people. Everywhere you turn, they're running here, they're running there. There's crowds piling up at the stores, or they're here, they're there, they're trying to find something, they're looking for something, they're trying to find some kind of peace and comfort from all that's going on, and there's so much turmoil and fear and anxiety in this time frame. And yet the Bible says, and I want to zero in on this portion of the text, because the Bible says here in verse 25, "And a woman was there who had been subject to bleeding for 12 years, and she had suffered a great deal under the care of many doctors, and spent all she had, yet instead of getting better, she grew worse mentally, emotionally, physically, spiritually." This woman had come to a place where she was unclean, this hemorrhaging that was taking place for 12 years. And so she felt alone, even though she was amongst the people. She was afraid. She was trying to find healing. She was looking in doctors. She was looking just like today. There's people, they're afraid. They're hearing coronavirus and they get a sniffle. They cough and everybody starts to ostracize them and push them aside. And they're afraid to come to the doctors in fear that they might be tested and be told that they've got this disease. And so they don't know what to do. And this woman was in that same category. She was struggling. She was afraid. But yet she came and she listened, the Bible says. In verse 27, "When she heard about Jesus, she came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak." In other words, she was like so many today, afraid to come, or maybe because they want healing but don't know how to approach. She came and she listened. She heard that Jesus was able to heal. Jesus was able to deliver. Jesus was able to make it okay. And she just wanted to come up and just kind of touch the hem of his garment. She didn't want to bother him. She didn't want to try and get in the way. She just kind of wanted to come in the side like so many and just get a healing, a touch from God and go on her way. But yet we see that this woman, she came to a place where she thought, well, if I just touch the hem of his garment, I'll be healed. She had the faith to believe. That's one thing, is so many people come and throng around Jesus. They come to hear the word of God, but they come lacking in the faith that's needed for the healing and the salvation of their souls, for the deliverance of whatever addiction, whatever problem, whatever fear, whatever anxiety is upon their lives. Yet the Bible says in 1 Peter 5:7, cast your cares upon him because he cares for you. God cares about our pains. He cares about our hurts. He cares about our struggles. And the Bible says to bring them to him. And here this woman comes and she had the faith to believe. And she listened. She heard. She knew that there was something different here. And she was willing to reach out and touch him by faith because the doctors couldn't heal her. The pains that she went, it didn't help her. She just grew worse, the scriptures say. But immediately, the Bible says her bleeding stopped and she felt in her body that she was freed from her suffering. Think about it, 12 years in this agonizing pain, 12 years in this feeling of hopelessness and helplessness and struggling and afraid and people looking down and walking away from her because this woman was no longer looked at in that place because she was unclean, because there was something wrong with her. Just like people tonight that you might know or we're hearing on the news and they're talking about coronavirus and they're sick and stay away 6 feet and all of a sudden everybody's afraid and you see someone cough and it's like, don't cough on me. Don't cry, don't sneeze on me. You know, and the thing is, and now we begin to make them feel like there's no hope. And isn't that place we need to be sensitive. We need to be sensitive to their needs. The Bible says she felt her healing. She felt something happen inside. And at once the Bible says that Jesus realized that power or virtue had gone from him. And he turned around in the crowd and he asked, who touched my clothes? See, Jesus knew. He knew that virtue had gone. He knew that someone had reached out by faith. But, but he wanted to come to that place and he wanted to bring her to the attention. She wasn't just a face in the crowd. She was important. Her pains, her suffering, her struggles, they were real to him. And he wasn't so busy that he was saying, you know, I'm on my way to pray for this little girl that's dying. He stopped. His focus now turned on this woman. He felt the healing virtue flow. He knew that she had been touched. But he wanted her to understand it wasn't just a touch and go. He wanted to be personal. He wanted to be real with her. He wanted her to know that she could come to the feet of Jesus and find healing and forgiveness. She could find that healing for her soul. Because it was more than just a physical. It was a mental. It was an emotional. It was a spiritual attack upon her being. And when Jesus began to look, the disciples said, you see the people crowd against you. His disciples answered, and yet you ask, who touched me? The Bible says Jesus kept on looking. He looked intently into the crowd because he wanted each and every person that was there, that had a need, that was there for the same reasons, but maybe lacking in faith or worry or doubt were there and were standing just watching. But he was giving this person an opportunity to come forward, to let her know or him know that he knew that she had been touched because of the faith she had to reach out and to believe. And he was watching. And the verse 32 of the Bible says, but Jesus kept looking around to see who done it. Then the woman, knowing what had happened to her, came and fell at his feet, trembling with fear, and told him the whole truth. I want you to think about this. Her healing didn't come in the fullness of it till she stopped and realized that Jesus was looking at her. Jesus was taking time to call upon this individual that was struggling in faith or in her need. And when he reached out and he said that, she stopped, she came, and she knelt before him. She told him the truth. She was honest with herself. She was honest with him. She was honest before the crowd. She had a need, and she was believing for her miracle. And when she felt that healing power flow upon her body, she felt the healing. She knew that she could come and she could cry out. And Jesus looked down, and Jesus began to minister to her. And I want you to think about this, because in verse 34, he says, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace and be freed from your suffering." I want you to think about this, because here was a woman who didn't attend church. She couldn't be around the crowd because she was unclean. She had this disease, these things that had come upon her. And yet we begin to look, and Jesus brings her back into the fold. Jesus accepts her, and he calls her daughter. She wasn't just a woman in the crowd. She wasn't a face in the crowd. She was now being called by Jesus daughter. She was received. Her faith brought healing to her spiritually, mentally, emotionally, and physically. The Bible says that he said, rest and peace of mind in her soul. These were things that she was struggling. These were things that she had in her being. He said, go in peace. Go in peace and be free from your suffering. Rest in a peace of mind, a peace of soul. She was healthy. She was made well in her body. She no longer had the disease because she had the faith to believe. And maybe tonight, today, as we're here, you might be struggling. You might say, I've got this thing, or I'm afraid of this virus that's around me. I'm afraid of what's going on, and I'm afraid for my family. But Jesus is saying, son, daughter, don't be afraid. God, you've got peace. You got a peace that the world can't take and the world can't give. And in the midst, you can find comfort for your soul, because God is greater than every disease. God is greater than any situation that's there in our midst. And so tonight, as we're here, whatever you're going through, whatever's taking place in your life, know that you can find the strength, the hope, the comfort, and the peace that you need through Jesus Christ. And right now, we're just going to have everyone bow their heads and take that time to pray with you. Maybe you're here today and you're struggling. Maybe today you're going through some things and you just need the touch of God. Maybe like this woman, you're battling some things, some fears. Maybe you need healing in your mind, your heart, your soul. Jesus is able to bring healing. And I want to pray for you. And those of you that are watching, I want to pray for you. Maybe you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. But today, like that woman who came as a face of the crowd, and Jesus brought her in, and she no longer was a face in the crowd, she was the center in the crowd. And it was one-on-one. It was special. It was precious. It was real. Maybe today, just saying a simple prayer with me. Jesus, I need healing. I need forgiveness for my sins. There's things in my life that I need to surrender. There's things that I need to let go. And I need you, Lord Jesus, to break the chains, to set me free, to make me whole. And you said that little simple prayer. You cried out with faith. You reached out like this woman to touch the hem of the garment of Jesus. You can find your healing. Healing of mind, healing of heart, healing of soul. Because God cares about you. He cares about the things you go through. He loves you with an everlasting love. We don't have to be filled with stress and anxiety, but we can come and we can find and draw strength and hope in the everlasting love and arms of the living God, because he loves us. We can come to the altar of God and find forgiveness, find peace of mind, peace of heart, comfort and strength, Let it be the anchor of your soul. Let it be the strength of your heart today. And again, we just want to take this time to tell all of those that are watching and all of you that are here how much you're loved, how much you're appreciated. And here in the New Harvest Long Beach Church, we care about you. We're praying for you. We're praying for this community.